Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Once again, welcome back to Technology Hub by Talha, dear viewers. So today we are going to discuss 2D arrays, the visualization of 2D array and how we can access the elements from the 2D array and how we initiate it. And after that, we are moving towards the different coding schemes. Okay. So right now, revise the concepts of 1D array. Okay. Now it's just like if we are talking about the visualization of 2D array and 1D array. Okay. So how we declare the 1D array? Now it's just like int a parenthesis 4. Okay. That means we declare an array with the name a, having the integer type variables in it and having the length 4. So it means we take 4 elements in this array. And it's just like this. And if we are talking about the declaring the 2D array, now it's just like int a in the parenthesis, suppose 3 and then the 4. How we can visualize it? Now it's just like if we are talking about the array of arrays. That means we are having an array which have multiple arrays in it. Now it's just like if we are talking about the 3 and 4 array, means we are talking about the 3 rows of arrays or the 3 different arrays. It's just like array number 1, array number 2 and this array number 3. And after that, each array having the 4 length or having the 4 elements in it. So combinedly, if we sum up all these arrays within a single 2D array, that's the concept of 2D array. And we declare this 2D array is just like this, int a within parenthesis 3 and after that within the parenthesis 4. So right now we have this matrix type structure. So it's just like 3x4 matrix. So in which 3 rows and having the 4 columns. So we can also say that if we are moving towards this array A of 3 and 4, that means 3 represents the number of rows and 4 represents the number of columns. There is in front of you like this. Now moving towards the initialization of 1D array and the 2D array as well. So if we are talking about the initialization of 1D array, it's just like integer a in parenthesis 4. That means we are taking 4 elements in this array. And which elements? Suppose equals, after that within the curly braces, we take the different elements by separated with the commas. It's just like 6, 7, 8 and 9. So if we talk about the placements in the array, it's just like 6 placed on the 0th index of this array, like here. After that, 7. So 7 placed at the next index, that is the 1th index of this array. After that, then we are assigning the 8. So 8 will be assigned towards the 2nd index, index number 2 in this array. And last and the least, we have 9. So 9 will be placed on the next index, that is index number 3. So index number 3 having the 9 element now. So it's a simple structure of the single dimension array, okay, or the one dimensional array. Now we are moving towards the two dimensional array. If we are talking about the initialization of 2D array, now it's just like this, int a within parenthesis 2 and after that 3. That means 2 represents the number of rows and 3 represents the number of columns. So if we are talking about each value separately, then we can say that we are having the two dimensional array which having the indexes 0 and 1 for the rows and the 0, 1 and 2 for the column values, and in which we have to place these numbers one by one. So it's just like firstly 3 will be placed on which index? 0 and 0 index of this array. It's just like this. And the second number, suppose we are talking about the 4. So 4 will be placed on which place? After that, what's the next number? That is the 5. So 5 will be placed on the index number 0 and 2. After that, what will be the next number? That is the 6. So 6 will be displayed on the next row. So 6 will be placed here. And after that, 7. 7 will be placed on the next index. And after that, we have the 8. So we have the 8 on the immediate next index of this 7. So through this method, we have to initiate all these numbers, okay, And we also have another method that is more feasible from this method. So let's move towards the second method. It's just like if you are declaring the integer a, so the array having the rows 2 and columns will be 3, equals, after that in curly braces we are taking two rows separately within the separate curly braces. It's just like 3, 4 and 5 within another curly braces, and we are managing 6, 7 and 8 within another curly braces. So if we are talking about the placement within the two-dimensional array, so 3, 4 and 5, that will be appear in the front row or the first row of this array, and after that we are moving towards 6, 7 and 8, and 6, 7 and 8 will be placed on the second row of this array. Now we can check it out how we can access the elements of two-dimensional array. Now it's just like if we have this two-dimensional array, okay, we are having the two rows and three columns, okay, and we are having the different values here, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7 and 8. So now if we are accessing a of 0 and 0, that means first 0 represents the row index, that means the row number is 0, and after that next 0 will be represented as a column index. Which column will be used here? So that is also 0 in this case. So in this case, if we are accessing a of 0, 0, that means we are accessing the 0 row and 0 columns value, that is 3. And if you understand this concept, then moving towards other elements, how we can access it? Suppose if we are talking about a of 0 and 1, that means I am talking about a of 0, 1 means that value is 4. And if we consider a of 0 and 2, that means we are moving towards value 5 here. And if we access the 1 and 0 here, then we are moving towards the 1 row and 0 column, that means we are moving towards which value, that is 6. And after that, if we are moving towards a of 1 and 1, that means row number is also 1 and the column number is also 1. That means we are talking about the 7 value. And if we access the value with the a of 1 and 2, that means we are talking about the value 8 here. Okay? So whenever we display something or we can input a number from user, then we have to use these techniques. Now let's moving towards how the memory occupied by the 2D arrays. Firstly, if we have this two-dimensional array, suppose we are having the two rows and three columns here, okay? Now it's actually for our understanding. So if we are talking about the memory structure, so computer memory structure is always in the linear fashion. It's just like this, okay? And if we are talking about the linear fashion, then this two-dimensional array having the two rows and three columns, actually for understanding in your mind, actually it will be represented on the single linear fashion in the memory. It's just like this. And if you are talking about the exact memory structure, then we can say that the one element of an array contains the 4 bytes actually. It means if we are talking about the one element having the 4 bytes, and if we consider these 6 values or the 6 elements, then we are moving towards 6 multiplied by 4, that is 24. So these 6 elements of this array having the 24 bytes in the memory. So it's just like this. The actual memory structure is just like a linear memory structure in front of you. And if you are talking about the first number, that is 3. So 3 suppose will be placed in the memory structure, and 3 itself having the 4 bytes. Now suppose it contains the 100, 101, 102 and 103. That means these 4 bytes will be consumed by the a of 00, that is value 3. So 3 contains the 4 bytes from 100 to 103 suppose. So after that, if we are talking about the value 4, so 4 contains the next 4 bytes, then the 5 contains next 4 bytes, then the 6, then the 7, and after that 8 contains the next 4 bytes, and it's just like 120 to 123. So this two-dimensional array contains these memory elements on these places actually. Suppose if we are talking about the starting from 100 and it ends 1, 2 and 3, 123. And after the memory structure, let's move towards how we can display the two-dimensional array with the help of code. Okay, if we are talking about the single-dimensional array, with the help of single loop, we can display the one-dimensional array having the multiple numbers in it. So if we are talking about now the two-dimensional array, then we can say that we have to use now two for loops, okay, the nested for loop structures. One will be used for the row numbers and the second one will be used for the managing the addresses of column numbers. So firstly, if you are talking about this code in front of you, so we are having the two for loops, okay, the nested loops here, and after that we have to display it. Now let's moving towards the execution of this code. Suppose firstly, if we are talking about the initialization of this array, initialization of this 2D array is just like int a of 2 and 3, okay, now it's just like this in front of you, the two dimensional array. So we are managing the row numbers and actually the column numbers here with the help of integers I and j, suppose. So let's consider the first for loop. That means integer I equals 0. We declare the variable I and I having the value 0, as it shows in the figure also, I having the value 0 now. And check the condition, while I is less or equals to 1, the condition is true. If the condition is true, then we will moving towards the inner for loop. And within the inner for loop, we are having another integer, that is j. Integer j equals 0 initially, so j's value will be 0 now, as we can show in the visualization here, j equals 0. And after that, condition will be checked. Now the condition is j is less or equals to 2. Condition is true now. If the condition is true, then we are moving towards the body of this for loop. Now in body of the for loop, we have to display a of I and j with the help of cout statement simply. A of I and j means we are having the value of I is 0 and having the value of j is also 0. That it means it becomes a of 0, 0. That means we are talking about the value 3 here, okay? So this program print 3 firstly on the output screen. And after that, we are moving towards again increment in j within the for loop. Now the j's value will be 1 instead of 0, okay? Now j is 1. And now check the condition once again. J is less or equals to 2. Once again, condition will be true. Yes, condition is true. So moving towards the body of the for, we are displaying a of I and j. That means a of 0 and 1. It means we are talking about which value? The value is 4 here. So the output will be 4 also. And after that, the increment of j in the inner loop, okay, the j's value will be 2 now. Now check it out, 2 is less or equals to 2. Condition once again is true. If the condition is true, then we are moving towards body of the for loop and we have to display a of I j. That means now we are talking about the value 5 here. So the 5 will be printed on the output screen. After that, once again, increment in j. Now j is becomes 3. Now check the condition once again. J is less or equals to 2. Condition is false now. So because the condition is false, then we are moving towards out of this inner for loop. And then just we have to display the next line. Okay. And after that, moving towards the first for loop. And we are having the increment in I here. So the value of I is now 1 instead of 0. Now check it out once again. While I is less or equals to 1, condition is true or not? Now the condition is true. If the condition is true once again, then moving towards inner loop once again. And we are having j equals 0 once again. So the j is 0 now and the I's value will be 1. The condition is true. So if the condition is true, then we are moving towards the body of the for. And we are displaying which number? That is 6. So it prints on the output screen as well. Next, move towards increment in j. Now the value of j will be 1 now. So 1 is also less or equals to 2. condition once again is true. If the condition is true, then we are moving towards display statement, okay, with help of cout, and then we have to display a of ij. Right now the 7 will be displayed here, and then we are moving towards once again increment in j within the for loop, and then value of j will be 2 now. If the value is 2 now, check the condition once again. 2 is also less than or equals to 2. If the condition is once again true, we are displaying value 8 here. Okay, after displaying the 8, the last element of this array, then moving towards once again increment in j. So the j's value will be 3 now. And check the condition. 3 is less or equals to 2. Condition is false now. So we are moving towards outside of this inner for loop, and we are having the end line, okay, the next line statement, and after that moving towards the increment in I. So if the value of I is right now is 2, then check the condition. 2 is less or equals to 1. The condition is false now. So we are moving outside of this outer for loop, okay. So the whole program's output will be the complete two-dimensional array that having the values 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. So now guys, if we are talking about the programming, okay, suppose in the compiler, suppose we are talking about the Dev C++, okay, and we are moving towards a few programs with the help of two-dimensional arrays. Suppose we are having this code in front of you, actually the same code, firstly, we are discussing. After the header file in the main function, we are initializing a two-dimensional array that is having the value 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. After that, with the help of two for loops, we have to display it as we discussed earlier. Now check it out. What's the output of this exactly? I have to run it, okay? When we execute it, and I execute it, now what will be the output right now? The, all the elements of this two-dimensional array. On the first line, we have 3, 4, and 5. And in the second line, we have 6, 7, and 8. So that's exactly the same code we are already discussed. Let's moving towards another code right now. It's just like this. If we input the values of this two-dimensional array with the help of user, and after that we have to display it, then for input as well, once again we are moving towards these two nested for loops, okay, and within two nested for loops we are using the display statement, suppose enter the number. After that, user have to input some number. Then one by one, user enters all these numbers of this two-dimensional array, and after that, with the help of next two nested for loops, we are displaying that array. Okay? So, if we run this program, suppose I have to execute it right now. Okay? Now check it out. What's the output of this? Enter a number? Because now user have to enter these numbers for this two-dimensional array. I firstly enter 2, okay, then once again it shows the entered number, then we enter 3, then I enter 4, then I entered 5, then 6, then 7, okay. So after that I have to enter it. Now what's the output of this? All the elements of two-dimensional array are displayed. Now it's just like 2, 3, 4, and in the second row we are having the 5, 6, and 7. So finally, we have covered all the aspects of the two-dimensional array, or we are simply having the multiple dimensional array as well, or the multi-dimensional array. So visualization of two-dimensional array is very clear to you. How to initialize a two-dimensional array, and how to access the elements of two-dimensional array, and how we can display two-dimensional arrays elements. These all are very clearly in front of you now. So never forget to subscribe Technology Hub by Talha. Thank you so much for watching.